Hey, are you wondering about the mainframe technical exchanges that Broadcom puts on? We just had one in April here in Prague. You've probably seen some episodes that we filmed. But now you have the chance to join us as we interview customers and colleagues alike on the floor, asking them one question. What's something that they learned as part of the sessions? Now, I also have to give a shout out because we're going to have another live mainframe technical exchange in October in Plano, Texas. So if this inspires you or you find the topics interesting, please consider registering and joining us at that MTE. Tom McQuitty, always a pleasure. How is MTE treating you?
MTE has been fantastic. I've been loving all the sessions. All the tracks have been great.
That's awesome. And so can you tell us either one thing that you've learned already in sessions or something that you're looking forward to learning more about?
I've been enjoying the hands-on sessions around ZOSMF, so being able to do API loading and using some of the libraries to be able to access that through modern languages.
And really get hands-on then.
Hands-on, absolutely.
That's awesome.
Yesterday I attended a session on HostBridge, and it does a lot more than I ever realized it could do. So a part of me is like, oops, I should have known better. But that was really cool and exciting. And then overall, I love hearing the stories from the customers of how they're using our products and better understanding their business cases. And I thrive on that. So that is what I come here for. And that's what I'm looking forward to the rest of the conference.
I learned that people are interested in platform engineering.
Okay.
Which actually came out from the session that you have. Okay. The team build, which was interesting. So we are just working on connecting those the right people to talk about it. But yeah.
And that's exactly the forum for it. We want to connect the experts with the customers.
Absolutely. That's the reason.
I'm always surprised by our customers all having very different requirements in different mainframe environments. And so I've really just enjoyed the opportunity to learn from them, simply as to where they're all at along that journey, all of the journeys that they've got going on. And just hear from them as to how they're going.
I learned a lot of interesting stuff, especially on the workshop Gen AI.
Okay.
Well, this was called Explanation, and I'm looking forward to it.
Did you get to put hands on keyboard even?
Yes, it's amazing.
That's amazing.
You should try it.
Yeah, something that I've learned during the MTE so far is actually several different VS Code shortcuts that's going to make my development life a little bit easier.
Oh, that's perfect.
So I've gotten to sit in on a couple of different VS Code sections, and everybody's doing it a different way, and so there's some pretty helpful stuff there.
It's always helpful to see how other people do things.
I have learned quite a few things about the new features and technologies that we are bringing to the market. I have been able to see in action and to stay into workshops and see the things moving, which is always much better than any speech or than any presentation. And I have met a bunch of great new people and make new connections. So it's not one thing, it's a lot of things, and it's been great.
So one thing I have learned at this MTE is certainly everything that is related to AI and generative AI.
Okay.
It's very exciting. From the feedback we hear from customers, there is still a lot that they are expecting.
Yes.
And everybody is dreaming about. And then what I still want to learn about in MTE is the vision and the future steps with regards to test for Z.
Okay.
Because also testing is one of the very important aspects of DevOps.
Oh, I'm always looking for something else to learn, but so far I learned that I need more content for our sessions. We're doing sessions and they're short on content.
And they're short on the content?
Yeah.
But was the interaction with the customers good?
Yeah, and they were perfect. That's why it was short. We expected some issues to appear, but there was nothing. And so that's
why. So it was too...
Yeah, too smooth.
Too smooth. Yeah. Well, that's not a problem.
Yeah. Ah, man. So,
I say congrats to that. Okay. That means success.
This week, I think the first thing, I made a lot of networking. I met with a lot of customers, and our workshop, it was great. I had an opportunity to talk with the people who are using our products or who may use in the future.
And that workshop was on Code for Z and what else?
So my workshop, it was about Code for Z, and it is about COBOL code changing, debugging, compiling. And it's all happening on VS Code. So we are offering a modern environment for the COBOL developers. And yeah. That's a great opportunity.
I've learned about AI.
Okay.
It's very excited about it, so can't wait to use it.
Okay.
We've learned about dashboards,
okay.
Dora metrics, all kind of metrics. Mm-hmm. Provided a lot of feedback. Hopefully by the end of the year, we'll be able to see some proof of concept.
Perfect. So, yeah, within your Endeavor environment, yeah?
Yes, correct, correct.
I learned that more and more customers doing mainframe modernization. So this is very, very comforting because we started the journey 2-3 years ago and we thought that we are alone, but we are not alone. That's a good point. Many aspects with the new modernization, Python integration, ServiceNow integration, is a lot of new integration, so a lot of tools for us as a mainframe business specialist to promote our solution and to, at least for mine, for French customer. But good to know that other are committed and engaged in this solution.
So, and you're going to ask?
I'm going to ask you, don't worry.
What are you going to ask?
Don't worry.
I did enjoy the MRI session, so it's a great, great tool and great product that the Broadcom's team is introducing, and it does give the mainframers an idea of what they have and what they can run the analysis and understand how they can build their strategy for the future.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Are you looking forward to the next MTE?
Yes, I am. I'm planning to be here and see you here next year.
One thing that stood out was we've been doing quite a lot of work at one of our customers in Australia on the modernized application environments. And I thought we were done. And I found that there's a whole additional cloud-based development environment that we can expand to in the future. So that was one of the things that really stood out for me.
And that's exciting because we can actually connect one of the customers here in Europe with that customer in Australia, share the story of what they're doing.
Absolutely, and he seems very, very willing to chat to them. So.
Certainly.
I learned that the food is different here.
Certainly true. Certainly yeah. True.
But I learned that like some of the culture is different than the United States. So, You know, getting to meet people from different cultures is always a great thing. You know, so because EMEA doesn't just encompass one thing. Like all of our conferences in the U.S. is usually encompassing Americans.
Exactly.
But, you know, coming over here, you get to meet people from Czech. You get to meet people from the U.K. and all over Israel. So it's a great experience.
Well, actually, yesterday we went out with some customers and I was pleasantly surprised, you know, how much they love our products. Seriously, in the customer care, they were mentioning another vendor who wouldn't really care much about their issues. And I mean, we hear it internally,
yeah.
But actually hearing it, you know, from the customer himself was nice to hear. Yeah.
Did it help that you were feeding them drinks or?
I don't think so. But it was heartwarming, you know, to hear it.
No, certainly. That's one of the best things about this conference.
What have I learned this week at MTE?
Yeah.
I have made amazing connections with people from my past as well as new customers. And I am always amazed at the energy that we have amongst ourselves in Broadcom and how that, you know, shows itself to our partners, our customers. And, you know, we have cool technology, but the people behind it and the employees behind it just comes through in this conference. So I think that's the amazing thing I've learned.
I'll say it's something that a customer taught me.
Okay.
They were kind enough to share with the group some metrics, some analytics they had done on their cost of transactions that they run over time. Mm-hmm. And they were able to correlate the spikes in transactions to changes that they made in Endeavor in their actual application. And it's pretty impressive, but what he said, it would be more impressive if they could show that before they actually saw the spike, right?
Yeah,
they're doing
of course.
It afterwards.
Yeah.
And collating it, but essentially small changes from an application programmer can make a huge difference in the cost that it takes to run their business, and they don't know it until production time.
Yeah.
So we've had a recent acquisition of the AP4Z, application profiler for Z technology, and I think that could really help the customers understand this before it gets a spike in production.
Reports are good, but
Yeah, exactly.
Much better to know in advance.
Right.
One thing that stuck out for me in general is the journey that organizations have been on the modernization aspect of it.
Okay.
We've been talking about this for a while, but now to kind of see the results and customers actually sharing this success story has been like amazing to see. I mean, it's one thing for us to build the tools, but when you start seeing the results from customers and the value that they're getting out of it and them talking about it, and multiple of them talking about it, I think has been the best part. So that's one thing that I, learning the fact that they're getting value and using our products has been great for me personally.